Hi, this is Stefan with 3CX, and welcome to our third part of configuring Microsoft 365 with 3CX. And in this episode, we are looking into connecting users which have a Microsoft 365 phone system license via the Microsoft Teams direct routing to 3CX. And that will enable the users with this license to call all extensions within 3CX, but also can make outbound call and receive incoming calls from the PSTN network to either the 3CX extension or to the Teams client. Now, first thing to be said first, this requires time, so most likely we can only do the setup here, and then you need to give it some time until your Teams client will understand that it can make phone calls. As we can see here, we have two users which have a phone license attached. The other boss not, so these we cannot configure for it and will later be not subject to it, neither. And somebody is driving a loud car at the moment outside. And as we see, when we look at the same user's Teams client at the moment, this looks basically the tab of phone calls at the moment. And now we want to extend this so that we get a dial pad here to call external numbers or 3CX extensions. For this, we need the 3CX management console, and we need access to the Microsoft platform for a global administrator. In settings, Microsoft, we configured in our two episodes before the general connection to Microsoft. We synchronized the users so far, except the administrator. We allowed sign-in of users to the management console and to the web client for end users. And now we're going to the last part, and we are configuring direct routing for Microsoft, which will be asked to insert an FQDN where Microsoft Teams will connect to. And this needs to be within your email domain. So if you have installed 3CX on a 3CX provided domain, you need to find here now a domain you own, and it must be within your own email domain. As you can see, our email domain configured here on the other side is marketing-3cx.com. And in this domain, we need to create now also an FQDN, which points to your 3CX phone system. In my case, I will use marketing-3cx.com, and we need to upload now a certificate which is covering exactly this FQDN. Microsoft has a very strict requirement who needs to be the issuer of this certificate, and I prepared myself already and got myself a certificate from one of these vendors, and I needed to download them quickly from my email provider again and upload them. We need once the certificate, and we need the private key for this certificate. As you can see, Microsoft Teams integration itself will run on a new SIP port, 5060 generally is for SIP, 5061 for TCP and TLS connectivity, and connectivity to Microsoft Teams is via the TCP port 5062, in the case that you are using a 3CX provided FQDN for the general installation. However, if you installed already your PBX with a custom certificate during installation, which is within your email domain, and you type in here the same FQDN as your custom FQDN here in the top, you will not be asked for the certificates, and you will do the same thing on port 5061. This is just a more common case here. And now we need to select for the dial plan to be used for the user. This is very necessary to bring a most normal dialing experience to the user, as in the default setup in Microsoft Teams, you would be required to only dial numbers in E164 format, which means it needs to start with a plus, which for many users is inconvenient while dialing. In this sense, we could take the dialing plan for the United States, where we don't need to specify an area code. If we would have, for example, Germany, and we would be living in Berlin, and the area code for Berlin is 030, you would enter here in this sense only 3-0, please, without the leading zero. Okay, to United States, and we generate a script which needs to be uploaded to Microsoft Teams. And the second script is a script which will configure your users for Microsoft usage, for Teams Direct Routing usage. When we look in the setup currently in Microsoft Teams, before we run the script and we go to voice and we go to buy plans, there's only the default warden in direct routing. We have no SBC, and in this case, SBC will be your 3.6 phone system, so you don't need to install any other software, and your routing policies are by default also not configured. And the users which we are adding, which need to be enabled for phone system usage, have as well currently only default policies applied. And when you run all these scripts provided through the 3.6 management console, all this will be configured for you. If you in the later stage want to add or remove users from the Microsoft Teams direct routing in Teams or in 3.6, you would need to run the script again. It's configured, needs to be restarted. Yes, we would like to restart in order to apply Microsoft Teams. Now, we need to run this in PowerShell, and if you have not configured already the Teams Microsoft applet to run Microsoft Teams command from PowerShell, don't worry, the script will do that automatically for you. Now we come to the point where we need to run the scripts in PowerShell. Now, there are multiple ways that you need to tell your operating system first how you are allowed to run these scripts due to execution policy rights. Alternatively, I load generally the scripts in the editor of my choice and run them after manually in a PowerShell window. And you don't need to worry about if you have not installed the Microsoft Teams applet and the module for PowerShell. It will be automatically installed if you don't have it. It will sign you in and then run the complete setup. So this is basically the content of the script. We would try to basically install the module. In my case, it's already installed, so we can basically ignore this part. Now we need to sign in, and now very important that we sign in here with an administrator account, which can do the configuration in Microsoft Teams. So beside global administrator rights, a user with Teams administration in this sense here is required. So log in to this user. That would be here. Sorry, marketing, the password, and let's go. And from here you can sit back and all the configuration on the Microsoft Teams sites and in the 3.6 site, that both systems will understand each other, will now automatically be created. Voila, this part is done. So we already check what has changed already so far in your Teams configuration. The first part is that, we give the page a quick reload. You will notice this you have to do a couple of times in the Teams admin interface, or there is a delay, as we don't want to wait too long. We do it. We basically created the SBC link, which matches exactly what we configured in here, Teams Marketing -36.com. Don't worry so much about the network effectiveness, the TLS connectivity, and the SIP option. This will start after 10 minutes, and when you start doing your first calls, until then, this is absolutely normal. The routing usage is automatically created, and we have some policies which basically attached. And all this will be now basically mapped on a user, and therefore we have the secondary script which we downloaded, which I again will run for my users from copy and paste. So let's remove this. Clear. Which now automatically sets all the informations we wanted for the users. So if you return back to the users and And you see we have added a telephone number. This is the office telephone number, which you configure for users in your Microsoft portal, which must be set. If you don't set it, the user will be skipped in our configuration. And generally, this should be the outbound caller ID the extension should have in 3.6. It will not be used directly as its outbound caller ID, but it's beneficial as you also in the user synchronization can say that you want to set this automatically so you avoid one configuration step in 3CX or in Microsoft Teams to do so. Okay, so if you look at the user back in Teams and open now the policies, you will see that some of the policies has changed. The calling policy to 3CX has been added and the voice route has been set for this user too. Now, that's again the client of the user, and you see we still don't have a dial pad. And this is something which now either can take up to 24 hours, and I advise that you regularly restart your Teams client, because on restart the Teams client is reprovisioning, reloading its settings in order to make basically phone calls between the two entities. If you have a lucky day, we will see a dial pad now immediately. Oh, still not yet, so we still have to wait, and as I said, this can take up to 24 hours. I would say I'm cutting the video for the moment for a bit, and once I see the dial pad here, and I will promise you I make no changes in between, I will resume the video and we do our first test calls from Teams to 3CX and vice versa. Thank you, till later. So here again, it took roughly 30 minutes and I restarted in the meantime a couple of times my Teams client, and now you see something has changed from before. Now we basically got a dial pad, and the dial pad appears out of three things. You need to have a Microsoft business subscription, you must have phone system or business voice as an add-on, and the configuration needs to be completed. And here we see it's extension 100, and if 100 we can look here, it's George, so it's basically a link. But you also see that the extension now is registered and the synchronization term has changed to MS365 plus Teams, because it's a Teams directable routable user for us now. And you also be able now to make phone calls from A to B, and I think the easiest to show this would if we basically call from Teams the voicemail of 3CX. After I place the next call, we already heard that we have.
Please enter personal identification number, then press pound.
And we can disconnect the call from 3CX, and you see it ended as well here. And from now on, we have a connectivity and call capability. So overall, I needed patience for the first 45 minutes after I made the initial configuration. Some Microsoft websites say it can be up to 24 hours that it will take. If we go back to the configuration in Microsoft, where before we had some errors and now we placed the first calls, you can see the TLS status is up, the SIP options are flowing back and forth. The network effectiveness will start to become green if you run at longer outbound calls on call. As you just saw that I made a phone call from my Teams client into 3CX, we also have a unified call history, which we can look on. So if you look at the call logs, you can see that the internal extension, even I dialed from my Teams client, basically is being reported. So if you run a call report at the end of the day for people who accept or make calls from their Teams clients rather than from a 3CX client or a SIP terminal attached to 3CX, will be reported exactly in the same case as before. The only calls which of course we cannot record is if one Teams client users is making a phone call to another one. If we go quickly to the web client of this user, what do you offer me? Yeah, GB, we have GB. Now we're getting a lot of windows open. Hopefully you can still follow me. I will cut it maybe later a little bit. So we start making the phone call.
Please enter personal identification number, then press pound.
My call status has actually changed as well in 3.6, and with this visible for everybody else in the organization. I hope you enjoyed how easy it is to configure Microsoft Teams. Yes, you need some time, some tips or tricks how I'm using it, and I hope you enjoy using the functionality. Until then, have a great day and bye-bye.